All right, guys, we're coming live today from Rochester, New York, and we are at the Rochester Museum of Cars. But the big story is not all these wonderful, beautiful cars back here, but actually the tribute that this place pays to our fallen heroes and our fallen Vietnam veterans from Rochester. There's over 280 fallen heroes from the area, and the actual museum is a part of the Chapter 20 of Veterans of America. They curate here, and the owner, from my understanding, is a huge supporter of Vietnam vets, besides a maniacal, crazy car collector. This is just part of his collection. One of the bigger passions that he has is supporting veterans, and this whole place is not just dedicated to cars. Throughout the entire place, you have on all of these pillars historical events that happened in Vietnam. Some of the gentlemen here were actually visited some of these areas. You have the wall here with 280 fallen heroes from Rochester. You have highlighted battles and places at Vietnam that were, you know, they're memorable for people in probably not a good way, in the sense that when you're in war, there's a lot of things that happen, and so many people get forgotten after the war is over. It's great to see veterans associations taking care of those who took care of us in our time of need, in our time that we needed to be safe. These guys ran to the front line and they took care of us, and it's time that more things like this exist to take care of those who took care of us, and also to document the history of what happens here. Because just because the time passed doesn't mean that that didn't happen or that didn't impact these people, or these people aren't changed because of it. And one of the things that I found out today at this museum, actually, from a couple of the gentlemen here that are veterans themselves, is this was kind of the first area to address PTSD, which we all know is a very big problem with veterans, and it's very prevalent in the veteran society right now. So it's great to know that there's organizations out there that are, that they're, before it was popular, they were doing this. So it's great to see these organizations out there taking care of people. And I would just say to you guys, if you can make your way to the Rochester Museum area and see Walt and see Ed here, and make sure you donate, because they make the money go towards great causes for veterans. They have a great network up here of people who try to help the veterans as best as they can, you know? And if you can't make it to the Rochester area and support your veterans, find a local veteran chapter where you're near, find the local POW support center, and reach out. I'm sure there's one near you. I'm sure there's a veteran center near you. And even if it's just volunteering your time to go down and talk with people, and whatever you can do, it's just another act of kindness. You know how I always say, try to keep those acts of kindness up. But yeah, man, as you can see here, you know, this is amazing American history. This was, you know, before cell phones, before everybody took pictures of everything. This is the last documented history. So, you know, I'm gonna videotape and do a montage now, some of the rest of this stuff here, so you guys can get a good view out of it all.